Good morning, dear students. Today, let us take a look at this question from the book Pathfinder, chapter Gravitation. Two planets, each of mass m and radius r, are moving in free space. So these are two planets, each of mass capital M and radius capital R. At an instant, their velocity vectors are v1 bar and v2 bar. So the velocities of these two planets are v1 bar and v2 bar. At this instant, the position vector of the second with respect to the first is r1 2 bar. The position vector of the second planet with respect to the first planet is r1 2 bar. Determine the condition under which they will collide. So how should these quantities be related, v1 bar, v2 bar, r1 2 bar, be related so that these both collide? So we can conserve the mechanical energy initially when they are at this position and finally before collision. So initial mechanical energy is potential energy plus the total kinetic energy. So finally they collide, their velocities are u1 bar and u2 bar. The final mechanical energy is potential energy plus the total kinetic energy. Next, we can see the center of mass velocity remains same as there are no external forces acting on this system of two planets. So if the velocities are v1 bar and v2 bar, the center of mass velocity is mv1 bar plus mv2 bar by m plus m. If the final velocities are u1 bar and u2 bar, then the center of mass velocity is mu1 bar plus mu2 bar by m plus m. So these both must be equal. Or we can say v1 bar plus v2 bar equal to u1 bar plus u2 bar. So we have written two equations in conservation of energy and center of mass velocity remains the same. Now the reason why we are writing these equations is we need to bring a relation in the given variables so that these two planets undergo a collision. So let us write one more condition, that is conservation of angular momentum about center of Earth. Now the center of the Earth is a non-inertial frame. So we need to draw a pseudo force on this planet. The torque of this pseudo force and the force acting on this planet about the center of Earth is zero. So what we can say is about the center of Earth, with respect to the center of Earth, the angular momentum of this system remains conserved. So the initial angular momentum about the center of the Earth is m into r1 2 bar cross v2 bar minus v1 bar, the velocity of this planet with respect to the Earth. If the final velocities during collision are u1 bar and u2 bar, the final angular momentum will be m into 2r bar cross u2 bar minus u1 bar. R bar is a vector from center of Earth to the center of this planet. Now there is one more condition that we need to impose so that we ensure the collision of planets. So just observe the motion of this planet. Now look once again. What we can observe here is the two planets did not collide. They almost collided, but they did not collide. When we wrote our conservation of energy equation and conservation of angular momentum equation, those two equations also take this into account. Now we need to eliminate this. We need to ensure proper collision of the planets. Now, if we take with respect to the center of Earth, the position vector of the center of this planet is 2r bar, and the relative velocity of this planet with respect to the Earth is u2 bar minus u1 bar. So not colliding will occur when these two vectors are perpendicular to each other or their dot product is zero. So if we impose 2r bar dot u2 bar minus u1 bar not equal to zero, then we are imposing the condition that they are colliding. As both planets have collided and left the scene, let us solve our equations and derive an expression to ensure collision. So I am numbering my equations 1, 2, 3 and 4. First, I am squaring this expression 4. So squaring expression 4, we get this term is greater than 0. So I am writing a dot b whole square equal to a square b square minus a cross b whole square. And this expression must be greater than 0. Now let us take these two expressions separately and find these two expressions in terms of known variables. So first let us have a look at this expression. Now this one is nothing but this equation 3. So we can write r bar cross u2 bar minus u1 bar equals r12 bar cross v2 bar minus v1 bar by 2. Okay, so we have solved this part of the expression. Next, let us look at this part. Now mod u2 bar minus u1 bar whole square can be written as u1 bar plus u2 bar modulus square minus 4u1 bar dot u2 bar. Now from equation 2 that we have, we can square both sides and we can write v1 bar plus v2 bar the whole square equal to u2 bar plus u1 bar the whole square. Substituting u1 bar plus u2 bar whole square from this expression, we can get this as v1 bar plus v2 bar whole square minus 4u1 bar dot u2 bar. Now all our terms are in known variables except this term, which is u1 bar dot u2 bar. We need to eliminate this u1 bar dot u2 bar. Now this is our conservation of energy equation. In this equation, I'm taking m by 2 common, and u1 square plus u2 square can be written as v1 square plus v2 square plus 2 into v1 bar dot v2 bar minus u1 bar dot u2 bar. We can cancel out half mv1 square, half mv2 square in the LHS and RHS. We can simplify this to find u1 bar dot u2 bar, and we get u1 bar dot u2 bar equal to half of gm by r12 minus gm by 2r plus v1 bar dot v2 bar. So finally we have found u2 bar minus u1 bar the whole square is v1 bar plus v2 bar the whole square minus 4 times u1 dot u2. So I put the value of u1 dot u2 in this place. Now if you simplify this expression, v1 bar plus v2 bar the whole square minus 4 v1 bar dot v2 bar will give us v1 bar minus v2 bar the whole square. So I'm just rewriting this expression in this way. We had started off with this condition, and now we have found the values of u2 bar minus u1 bar the whole square and this expression in terms of given variables. Substituting u1 bar and u2 bar in terms of the given variables, we get this equation. Now this final equation will divide by 4r square. So finally, for the two planets to collide, we get r12 bar cross v2 bar minus v1 bar whole square by 16r square must be less than v1 bar minus v2 bar whole square by 4 plus gm by 2r minus gm by r12.